Coach Smith, I'd like to start with you. This is not new territory for you and the Rams. How have you been able to build such a winning tradition at Colorado State?
I think you're looking at three of the reasons right beside me here. This is our starting defensive crew, and when you have a defense that can be as dynamic and be as adjustable as we've been able to be over the last couple of years, it really gives us a shot in every single game. And you know, I give a lot of credit to our to all of our long poles, but especially these three have really done a great job as seniors and leaders for us this year.
So in the first half, it seemed like a little bit of a defensive struggle between you guys and Sonoma. What did you tell your team at halftime to get them out of their shell offensively?
You know, we knew it was going to be that type of a game, having seen them yesterday, and I had a feeling it was going to be a slugfest. It was going to be hard for us to kind of get things going. You know, we didn't really say much at halftime, just kind of, you know, we talked about a few of the little things that they were doing that we could adjust to, and a few little adjustments we could make on offense and stuff like that. And we felt if we kept winning ground balls and doing a good job on faceoffs and clearing the ball, that we were going to be in good shape.
Already with one championship under your belt, what do you tell your team to motivate them to get that second one?
You know, we don't have a championship. We may have won one last year, but this team doesn't have one. So, you know, the championship's the end result, and the process is really what matters. So we're, you know, it's a cliche, but we're taking every game one game at a time. We really focused on this game because we knew it was going to be a battle. So, you know, now we move on to the next thing, and, you know, that we'll take care of getting ourselves motivated for that on Thursday. But today we were thinking about Sonoma, you know, all day long.
All right, thank you, Coach. If you'd like to pass it off to one of your players. All right, Tyler.
Yeah.
Holding a team like Sonoma State to only four goals, what kind of pride does that give your defensive unit?
Sure, yeah. I mean, they were a great team with great players. We knew it was going to be a dogfight going in. And everything we do is just Team D, and we're building every game in this tournament. We've built every year through the season. I mean, we trust each other. We've played together for 3 years now. And, I mean, we trust our D-mids. We trust our goalies, and it's just such a team concept to what we do.
What kind of preparation are you guys going to have on the day off preparing for BYU?
Sure. I mean, it's going to be on our minds. We're going to take a little bit of time just to refocus, you know, hydrate, get our bodies right. But, you know, we've played BYU so many times, and we wouldn't have it any other way.
Would you like to see some adjustments made to your defense, things that you think that you could have improved on after tonight's game?
Yeah, I mean, like I said, we just want to build every single game. I mean, there's little things that we missed tonight and when goals that went in. So, yeah, we'll talk about each goal and break it down as the day goes on.
All right, thank you, Tyler.
Yeah.
Hayden, what kind of legacy do you think that this season thus far leaves on the program?
Yeah, I mean, it's great. We have a very strong group of seniors, and, I mean, every day we just talk about the family aspect and seniors all the way. I mean, it's gone back 4 years now, and we've just grown up with each other, and we're a family. We say it every day. It's our mantra, and, I mean, it's going to be great going out with these guys like this.
What aspects of the senior leadership from this class do you want the underclassmen to take over when you leave?
Everything. No, I think it's definitely the leadership and just the lacrosse IQ that they all have. I mean, on and off the field, they're always together, always talking about lacrosse, and everyone knows each other very well where they're on the field and everything. So I think just the overall game and the leadership for sure would be good.
All right, thank you, Hayden.
Yeah.
Patrick, what's your impression of the tournament here in Greenville thus far?
I've been very impressed with the teams I've seen, especially Sonoma. We knew it was going to be a tough game, and our coaches did a great job of scouting them and getting us ready to play.
And so, as all three of you have been saying defensively, you guys have been solid. Do you think that has been not necessarily a motivation, but a way for your offense to get better because your defense has been playing them in practice every day?
I think it certainly helps, although we may play a different style. We don't have your typical defense where we have three monster guys. We're actually kind of undersized, but we have very high IQ, and we do well together, and we have really good awareness on the field.
So what kind of adjustments do you plan on making for your final four appearance on Thursday?
Honestly, just keeping it tight. We have a very simple defense, keeping communication up, and that's really as simple as that.
All right, well, once again, thank you guys for taking the time to do this interview. Congratulations on your win.